What's up, Hearthstone fans? Welcome back to another episode of The Curve, where we draw the biggest headlines from this past weekend on Curve. I'm your host, Simon Sottle-Welch. Let's do this. After the format change to the second season of Grandmasters, the playoffs now allow for the top four players from each division to advance to the final stage of the season. With this additional spot available, players can clinch spots earlier in the season. Chiantsu in the Asia-Pacific region is 9-1 in Division A. His continued stellar play locked him in as the first player to clinch playoffs in all of the regions. In Division B, we'll have to wait another week to see the playoff pitcher settle down, as all of the players are very close in the standings. Reigning world champion Hunter Ace was the second player to qualify for playoffs this weekend, as he won both of his matches. Again. The champ is truly firing on all cylinders and is looking like the favorite to claim the last European spot going to BlizzCon later this year. In the division over, Psycho, who led the last season in match score, continues to struggle. He's dropped his last 8 matches in a row and is currently sitting in last place. In the Americas region, none of the players have officially qualified for playoffs just yet. Just Saiyan was close this weekend, but lost to Amnesiac on Sunday night. In both divisions, the competition is getting stronger. Amnesiac in particular, who started the season 1-4, has won his last 5 matches and was even able to beat the number one player in his division. The region as a whole is going to have some very decisive results this coming weekend, and every game matters because of tiebreakers, so be ready for some intense matches. With the season closing, there is also the flip side of the tournament, where the last place players will be getting relegated from Grandmasters. Every player is fighting for their tournament lives, so keep an eye out for ETC, Race, Psycho, Viper, Blood Trail, and Patra, as many of them are in must-win situations to keep themselves from getting relegated. In this week's meta moment, we want to highlight Highlander decks. The current Highlander decks that were brought this weekend are Warrior, Mage, and Hunter. The key component of these decks is that they only have one of any individual card. Key cards in these decks usually consist of things like Zephyrus the Great, Siamat, and class-specific cards such as this expansion's versions of Elise, Reno, or Bran. Each deck is powerful in their own ways, and if you haven't tried them, take a look at Firebat's VODs and deck lists from this past week to see 2 different Highlander decks in action. If you missed any of the Grandmasters action, you can check out the VODs on our YouTube page, youtube.com/HearthstoneEsports. Grandmasters resumes this weekend. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. That's it for us. We'll see you in the tavern.